So, my name is Manuel Schön. I'm from the company Pilz. This is here nearby. And we do all about safety, especially for industrial environment. And my topic today is the presentation of the safety certified manipulator. Maybe you have seen our manipulator on Tuesday in the arena event. We have a lightweight robot here, a lightweight manipulator, and the concept behind it is that we have service robotic modules for industrial and non-industrial environment. So what are our modules? The first module, maybe the interesting module for today, is our manipulator module. We also have a switching cabinet and a teach panel, and these three modules are an out-of-the-box robot system like everybody knows for industrial usage and environment. The other possible combination is our manipulator in combination with the ROS modules. I will have some words about this also later. Some technical facts. We have a manipulator that is had 6 kilogram payload. We have repeatability of 0.1 millimeters. We have a lightweight robot, 19 kilogram, and a reach of, let's say 740 millimeters. Now we come to the special parts. We have a power supply. The robot just needs 24 volts, and we have an can open interface to control our robot. So you do need not any special controller to control the robot. You can control it directly out of ROS. And of course, Pilz is known for safety. We also have a safe talk off function and a safe brake control directly in the robot. So why using ROS? I think everybody here has an answer for it, because it is easy to use. It is, we have sound also here. It is open source, and you can use it especially in industrial environment and in non-industrial environment. And this is a little bit the message we want to show today. Have it in both of these environments, and both of these environments have different different standards you have to check to get a CE certification, for example, for industrial environment. I think you already know Holly as well. She serves you some bread on the event on Tuesday. What we already have done in ROS is we have some packages launched in our repository on GitHub, where you can directly use the motion planning MOVIT to control our robot. And here, especially for industrial requirements, that means the behavior of the robot is, let's say, every time the same, and not on the one task this way, on the other task the other way, like we know it from industrial robots. We have linear point-to-point and circular movements implemented, and blending of these motions. We use the ROS can open interface to communicate directly with the drives that are mounted in the robot axis, and we also have these Python API, because we think that the engineers of the future will use code to program a robot, and not to use the programming environment of the robot manufacturer anymore in the future. So let's talk about what we have planned in the future. As I mentioned before, when you use service robotic modules in an industrial environment, the module itself has to rely on the ISO standard 10280-1. This is for the manipulator and the robotic system, and you have to take care about the 10280-2. This is for the whole application. So you have to do a safety check, CE marking to get it running in an industrial environment. The goals for a safe robot application in ROS. This is how we defined our goals. So the first goal is we want to establish ROS in industrial application, and we make the experience that safety is not the hottest topic when you do a ROS application. So we want to bring an out-of-the-box solution that you can use ROS with an industrial manipulator in a safe way, but you can just concentrate on your program. So yeah, as mentioned before, the robot do not need any special controller. No teach panel is needed, so you can control it directly out of ROS or move it. And so we are take care of the safety in this concept. And the concept is to be certified that we have a 10280-1 certification for our manipulator in the future. So yes, the integrator can focus on the application and not on the safety for the robot itself. What is the plan? How do we do this? As mentioned before, this is the industrial way. You have normally a safety PLC, you have a teach panel, you have an emergency stop. Here you can choose who is working on the robot, and you have a controller. This package here is already approved in combination with our module, and this is the normal industrial way. As we see in the presentations and slides before, a lot of people using ROS also in industrial environment, and so I called it here the future. Even for me, ROS will grow in industrial environments, and so we need also a safe solution for it. What is the idea behind? We have here a switch with RFID tags, so the user can put his tag in, and then the controller knows, is he allowed to control the robot, just to start a program or whatever. You need, according to the standard, you need a dead man switch here, and some safety that is around your programming device. The programming device in ROS normally is a PC, so you have to take care that these devices are next to your PC. This is directly connected to a safety PLC, and the safety PLC triggers the STO, safe talk off and safe brake control function of the robot. Here we have a deeper look into the standard. You need robot stopping functions. This is triggered by an emergency stop. This normally for this you need to slow down your robot. You have a deceleration and to get a smoothly stopping. Then in our case, the manipulator has these brakes, and these brakes go when an emergency is happen to break the robot in a safe way. For this, we have to make sure that the brakes are working. So we implemented a brake test that have to run every 8 hours. And this test is checking the brakes if they are already running in a safe way. So another topic is the operation modes. When you do teaching of an application, then you normally are inside the robotic cell, and the robot is just allowed to run with a reduced speed. And this switching between the speeds we already implemented in the ROS node. Here's another technical overview over the whole system. So as I mentioned before, we need this deadman switch. This is checked by the safety PLC. We have an emergency stop. This is also checked by the by the safety PLC. The safety PLC will trigger the safe talk off and safe brake control if anything has happened here. So You see here something very interesting, because ROS normally is not safe, and it also do not have to be safe, because when you have a safe concept behind your robot and your safety PLC, then the motion planning can be an unsafe motion planning. What is our timeline? When do we try the certification, and when did we start? We started in April this year. Do a lot of testing during the summer, and we plan to launch the certificated system in middle next year. Let's go a little bit deeper in the brake test. The robot must be able to brake safely. Why do we need a brake in the robot? Because when you mount a robot, let's say on the wall, then there is gravity that is acting to the robot, and if you just cut the power, then the robot will fall down and could hit somebody that is standing under the robot. So you need a brake to handle this movement, and this brake must be safe. So this brake gets triggered when an emergency stop is pressed, when the speed limit gets too high, and when a safe sensor triggers the emergency stop. We implemented these testing routines, and you can get all the informations about the testing directly to ROS, can use it for some diagnostics, and you also can execute the brake test directly out of our Python API we implemented. And we also have communication to the safety controller, to the safety PLC. The operation mode I mentioned before. In normal robotic application, we have three modes. We have the automatic mode. There is the robot running with the programmed speed, and normally the robot cell is closed in this mode. The robot cell has to be closed in this mode. So there is no possibility to get into or to teach some points with the open door. Then we have these called T1 mode. The T1 mode is the manual reduced speed. Here is a limit that is that is out of the standard. This is 250 millimeters per second, and this mode mostly is for teaching the robot. So in this mode, the robotic cell can be open. The let's say the laser scanner could be triggered, and but you also can move the robot. We implemented this with the TF frame, and Ross will monitor this TF frame in the during the operation. The other type is the type T2. The T2 is is similar to the T1, so you can run a T2 operation mode with open doors and full speed of the robot, but you have to press all the time the dead man switch. So if something happened, then the robot will stop immediately. This is for testing your application. So let's say we saw a gluing application in some presentations before. You cannot make a gluing application with reduced speed, because then your dispensing will dispense not in the right way. So therefore you need this T2 mode. I also have an example application. In our factory, normally we used four of these industrial cameras to detect the laser markings and the right mounting of this switching relay. And we planned to make it more flexible, to use a variety of switching relays to be checked by a robot. And therefore, we implemented our robot into the manufacturing cell, and the robot is now able to move with the camera around the switching relay and check for the markings and the right mounting. And this has to be done in ROS, because we have a big database, we make the communication between the database and the robot via ROS. And yeah, so this is an implementation of a safe robot in an industrial environment, controlled totally out of ROS. Let's have a small summary of this topic. We want to help ROS getting more into the industrial environment. What is needed for this? Something people who don't like so much, to get deeper into the safety topic, get this, and then therefore we plan to make it easy and out of the box. Our robot, the PRBT6, supports ROS natively, so you can run it directly out of MOVIT. You do not need any controller in between. And yeah, as I mentioned, we provide the safety, and you can focus on your application and coding. That's all from my side. If you have any questions.